Hello friends, I am Dr. Ravikumar Stephen. It is indeed a great pleasure to meet you once again through this audio presentation. In this video, I shall be listing out some herbals. So kindly pause this video and take a piece of paper and pencil or pen to note down the names. Thank you for investing the time to listen to this audio presentation. I congratulate you. You are making a good investment of your time for a better, healthy life. In this presentation, I shall be briefing little bit about the coronavirus. Then we shall go into the herbal, natural and food-based preventive medicines that will boost your immunity against the novel coronavirus. Coronavirus has been existing for several decades. Like every virus, the strains of coronavirus too was undergoing mutation, sometimes through animal interface and showing its face in different forms. In 2003, it took a stroll in East Asia in the form of SARS, and in 2012 in the Middle East in the form of MERS. SARS-CoV-2 is the cousin virus of SARS and MERS. SARS-CoV-2 was called COVID-19 and stands for 19th Chinese originated viral infectious disease. In my presentation, I shall call this virus SARS-CoV-2, severe acute respiratory syndrome coronavirus 2. Will I die if I get infected with SARS-CoV-2? No. 80% of the people will recover without any medical intervention. Rest 17% recover with symptom-based medical care. The mortality rate is only 2-3%, that too people who have pre-existing health conditions like diabetes, blood pressure, heart disease, tuberculosis, asthma, and those who are above the age of 60 years. Can a person infected with SARS-CoV-2 recover completely? Yes. Never stigmatize this disease, which is why many people try to escape quarantine. Start the morning with turmeric and dry ginger powder paste. The spices required are turmeric, ginger, and natural honey. Here I have listed how the turmeric is called in Tamil, Hindi, Malayalam, Marathi. And also I have given the botanical name I have also listed out how it is called, how turmeric is called in French, Spanish, Chinese, and Italian. Here I have listed how ginger is called in Tamil, Hindi, Malayalam, and Marathi. I have also given the botanical name. I have also listed how it is called in French, Spanish, Chinese, and Italian. Take 1 teaspoon, that is 5 ml of turmeric powder. Take half spoon, that is 2.5 ml of dry ginger powder. Mix both in natural honey. Lick to consume the turmeric and ginger paste. Paste with honey has to be licked to facilitate oral mucosal absorption, that is sublingual mucosa. Take 1 teaspoonful of cold pressed extra virgin olive oil before breakfast, but after fruit. There should be 15 minutes gap between the fruit intake and the breakfast. If you do not have access to olive oil, instead have 1 teaspoon of extra virgin cold pressed coconut oil. Coconut oil becomes unfriendly to heart only when it is heated beyond 300 degree centigrade. Eat at least 1 raw shallot a day. I have given the name of shallot in Tamil and the botanical name. In Mumbai, shallot is called the Madrasi Kanda. Please note, shallots are not onions. Here I have listed how shallot is called in French, Spanish, Chinese, and Italian. Have turmeric tea for evening. Spices required are turmeric powder, black pepper powder, dry ginger powder, cinnamon powder. Here I have listed how cinnamon is called in Tamil, Malayalam, Hindi, and Marathi. I have also given the botanical name. You need to buy Ceylon cinnamon, which will be tender and curly, and powder and use it. I have also given how cinnamon is called in French, Spanish, Chinese, and Italian. Here I have listed how black pepper is called in Tamil, Hindi, Malayalam, and Marathi. I have also given the botanical name for black pepper and also listed how it is called in French, Spanish, Chinese, and Italian. There are 2 steps involved in the preparation. Step 1. Take a airtight container. Take 3 tablespoons, that is 45 ml of turmeric powder, and put it into the container. Take 1 tablespoon, that is 15 ml of black pepper. Put the black pepper also into the container. Take 1/2 tablespoon of ginger powder, put it in the container. 1/2 tablespoon of bark of cinnamon powder, put into the container. Shake the container and mix it well so that the powder of different spices blend uniformly. This is enough for making 26 cups of turmeric tea. In this, I have given how the turmeric tea has to be brewed. Take 1/2 teaspoon, that is 2.5 ml of spice milk, spice mix, and put it in a cup. Boil 1 cup, that is 200 ml of water, and pour the water into the cup, which contains the spice mix. Stir well and cover it with a lid. Leave it for 5 minutes for the spice extract to dissolve into the hot water. Add 1 teaspoon, that is 5 ml of natural honey into the extract, stir well and drink. Remain hydrated, preferably with water laced with clutch tree wood extract. The other name for clutch tree is heartwood tree. Here I have given the Tamil name for clutch tree. I have also given the botanical name for clutch tree and also listed how it is called in Hindi, Malayalam and Marathi. Put few pieces of wood in water and boil the water. In Kerala, clutch tree wood is available in powder form for boiling. Many of you may not have access to the clutch tree. Hence, you can alternatively use black cummins. Drink the water that is boiled with black cummins. Black cummins is called in various names in the various Indian languages. I have given here how it is called in Tamil, Hindi, Malayalam and Marathi. I have given the botanical name as well. Also, I have given how it is called in French, Spanish, Chinese and Italian. The taste of black cumin is little bitter, hence add only little quantity. End your day with garlic milk. Ingredients required are turmeric powder, black pepper powder, garlic and milk. Here I have listed how garlic is called in Tamil, Hindi, Malayalam and Marathi. I have also given the botanical name for garlic. Here I have listed how it is called in French, Spanish, Chinese and Italian. Please note the difference between the garlic knob and the garlic cloves. Each knob will have 12 to 13 cloves. Peel 8 cloves of garlic and cut linearly into 2 and put it in a cup. Add 1 teaspoon, that is 5 ml of turmeric powder and put it into the cup. Add 1/2 teaspoon, that is 2.5 ml of black pepper powder and put it into the cup. Boil 200 ml of milk, that is 1 cup, and add the boiled milk into the cup and allow the garlic to get cooked. Add 1 teaspoon of raw sugar, preferably palm sugar. Stir it well and drink the milk and eat the garlic. If you take the above said food supplements, even if you get SARS-CoV-2, the virus can be contained with upper tracheal infection, which causes the pain below the larynx, and the possibility of virus spreading to the lower trachea is an impossibility. Take steam therapy. The process of doing steam therapy is heat up water in a large bowl to boiling. Carefully pour hot water into the bowl. Drape a towel over the back of your head. Turn on a timer. Shut your eyes. Slowly lower your head towards the hot water until you are about 8 to 12 inches away from the water. Be extremely careful to avoid making direct contact with the vessel or the water. Inhale slowly and deeply through your nose for at least 2 to 5 minutes. Don't steam longer than 10 minutes for each session. However, you can repeat steam inhalation 2 or 3 times per day if you are having too much of nasal congestion. When you have symptoms of infection, stay at home. Isolate yourself from the family. Ask family members to wear mask when they come near you, and you too need to wear a 3-layered mask. You will recover in 2 weeks, but take additional herbal bar food supplements. These are symptom-based herbal care. For fever, take green Krita extract before food. I have given how this particular herb is called in Tamil, Hindi, and generally it is called Nilavembu universally. I have given the botanical name of Nilavembu, and I have also given how it is called in Malayalam as well as in Marathi. This extract is available in the market. For cough, take purple fruited pea eggplant leaf extract. I have given the name how it is called in Tamil as well as in Hindi. I have given the botanical name as well. Also, I have listed how it is called in Malayalam and in Marathi. This extract is also available in the market for ready consumption. For breathing difficulty, take the extract of the leaf of Malabar nut, or it is also called Malabar nut is also called Adulusa tree. In Tamil, it is called Adadoda, and I have also listed how it is called in Hindi. I have given the botanical name for this herb and also listed how it is called in Malayalam as well as in Marathi. This extract is also available in the market for ready consumption. You can take these herbal supplements even if you are under allopathic treatment and the doctor has prescribed the following medicines, including the paracetamol 500 mg. Here I would like to drive home the point that herbal and food-based treatment is preferable to allopathic medicine. As of now, neither a vaccine or a particular prescription is available for SARS-CoV-2. What is given in the allopathic treatment is also symptom-based medical care and oxygen support for those who have breathing problem. Herbal and food-based treatment do not have much side effects. Drugs like Tamiflu contains cloxacillin, which has a potential to generate side effects on people who are allergic to penicillin. Though I tell all these, please get admitted in the hospital if the condition worsens after the 8th day, like difficulty in breathing. Now, the dietary plan to protect some of your internal organs. Apples, berries, beans, broccoli, flax seeds. These food items protect your lungs. For the protection of kidneys, take cauliflower, turnip, pineapple, blueberries, red grapes, cabbage, onion, and capsicum and radish. For the protection of liver, take coffee, oatmeal, green tea, avocado, beetroot, citrus fruit, and nuts. Some people may have allergenic to walnut, so please avoid taking walnut. For drinking water, use bark of clutch tree for boiling instead of the clutch tree wood. Take a small pieces of bark of the clutch tree and boil it and remain hydrated throughout the day. Bark is rare, but it is preferable than the wood. Listen to subliminal music. Our body itself has the therapeutic instinct, that is self-healing. Our body creates electrochemical signals to produce proteins like antigens and antibodies, which eliminates viruses. Subliminal music hastens the development of the antigen. What is this subliminal music? What you have been listening during this presentation, while I have been narrating, is the subliminal music. Please listen to the subliminal music for a while. Spend your time in silence. Realize you are in the universe and the universe is within you. Silence makes your body to communicate with the universe, the ever-expanding source of creation. When you are plugged to the creative energy of the universe, your body regenerates itself to make you healthy. Program your mind with positive words. Go Corona, go is not a bad word or a bad phrase, but one has to say it in full faith to program the antigen presenting cells to activate the T cells to produce immune responses. Let the placebo effect facilitate your cure. Pray with positive affirmation. While praying, instead of saying, "Protect me from all illness," say, "Make me enjoy the robust health." When you pray with positive affirmation, you become creative. Let your creative energy within you shall make you healthy. India has the infrastructure, so you need not worry about it. In 1911, the British government of India started Indian Research Fund Association with a specific objective of sponsoring and coordinating medical research in India. IRFA was renamed Indian Council of Medical Research in 1949. Under the leadership of Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru, in 1952, Virus Research Center under the auspices of ICMR and the Rockefeller Foundation was started in Pune. In view of its expanded scope and activities, the VRC was redesignated the National Institute of Virology in 1978. The good news is there from NIV. The National Institute of Virology has successfully isolated the 11 strains of SARS-CoV-2 and helped India to become the fifth country in the world to isolate the strain. The other nations are Japan, Thailand, China and USA. Isolation of the virus strains is the first step towards the development of drugs, vaccines and rapid diagnostic kits. I am sure the vaccine and drugs will be ready in the near future. Now let us see some do's. Cook food using olive oil at low fire, not exceeding 300 degrees centigrade, that is 572 Fahrenheit. Stop smoking. Stop drinking. Alcohol kills the SARS-CoV-2 only when the virus is outside your body. Inside your body, it tends to damage your liver. Do not eat blanched and raw vegetable till the epidemic is halted. Do not eat tandoori or grill cooked food or anything that is cooked in direct fire, which includes North Indian puppet. Do not use handkerchief. Instead, use disposable tissue papers. Do not buy single layered mask. Do not rush to testing center if you have symptoms. You need to go for SARS-CoV-2 virus test only if the cold, flu do not go in 3 to 12 days or if the condition worsens after the 8th day, like difficulty in breathing. Don't make yourself vulnerable to common cold. For this, you have to avoid eating vegetables like lady's finger and fenugreek leaf. They tend to make your body cold. Do not have cold drinks, ice creams, curd and lassi. Why should you worry about a possible course to virus infection when you have just a common cold? So avoid all this that promotes cold. Based on John Hopkins University report for India, the rise of SARS-CoV-2 cases started on the 23rd March 2020. The number of cases will be at the peak by 15th of April 2020. The epidemic will diminish by 25th September 2020. All over India, as per the predictive figures of John Hopkins, about 25 crores of people will be infected. That means 25 lakhs of people will be hospitalized. In the Indian state of Kerala, the number of people to get infection is over 80 lakhs and the number of people to be hospitalized is 80,000. In the Indian state of Maharashtra, the number of people to get infection is closer to 3 crores and the people to be hospitalized is closer to 3 lakhs. The ventilators needed for India is estimated to be 10 lakhs. The availability of ventilators in India is around 30,000 to 50,000. Isolating the elders could reduce the mortality rate. John Hopkins University projections can easily be disproved if we strictly adhere to the social distancing norms. This is a great challenge for every Indian. If you are under essential services and have to report for work, please follow the following guidelines. Take bath after coming back from work. If there is shortage of water, you need not take bath before going to work. Isolate yourself from the rest of your family members by confining yourself and your belongings in a separate room. Do not put your backpack, handbag on the floor, particularly during traveling. Women to cover their face with dupatta, stole, and men to cover their face with shawl while going out. Make sure which side of the stole or shawl that you are using for your onward journey. Use the other side of the stole, shawl for your return journey. Change the stole and shawl every day. Wear protective goggles for your eyes to minimize the risk of exposure to the virus. On reaching office, wash the goggles and your hand. Similarly, wash the goggles and hand after reaching home. My appeal to the research and development lab professionals, based on the success story of containing the SARS-CoV-2 infection at the upper trachea, I have made this presentation. Hence, do not leave out the herbs and spices in your research. The herbs to be researched are turmeric, ginger, garlic, black pepper, cinnamon, bark of clutch tree, green creta, climbing brinjal, Malabar nut, and black caraway. My appeal to the government. Way back in 1970s, master's degree programs were started on molecular biology and allied fields in the Madurai Kamaraj University. Most of them did not get job and had to take bank jobs. Similarly, in the early years of 21st century, several universities and colleges started biotechnology courses. Most of them became information technology professionals. The reason we do not have more research centers to employ such professionals. If there were more research centers like NIV, the chances of